There's one guy I should mention. We've mentioned a lot of people. The guy who choreographed the dance at the end of the film. He's called Longinus. Thank you so much.
Hello and welcome to our series on Indian cinema. Our topic today is designing song and dance in Bollywood cinema. Song and dance sequences in Hindi cinema are of prime importance, as not only it is a significant part of the film structure, as a part of the narrative, or simply as a spectacle, or an item number. Song and dance sequences have been an essential drawing factor for the viewers to go to a theater. Song and dance sequences also play a vital part in the Indian music industry, which is dominated and sustained by the film songs and music mostly. Today we have celebrated Indian dance director Longinus Fernandes with us to discuss this topic. Longinus is known worldwide for his strictly choreographed song and dance sequence, Jai Ho, from the Oscar winner Slumdog Millionaire. He was also awarded the prestigious Fred Astaire Award in 2019 in New York for best film choreography. He has choreographed song and dance sequences in more than 100 films and has won many Indian awards. Welcome, Longinus. It is great to have you here.
Thank you for this elaborate, what you say, introduction, which I really feel enthralled from within. Every word of yours was so much, you know, encouraging more than anything else. So thank you for your praiseworthy words. It means a lot to me. And I'm really thrilled to have a nice chat and a good conversation with you.
Firstly, my question to you is, how would you define Bollywood dance? It's a big thing across the world. But in terms of definition, what is your take?
Bollywood dance or dance in Bollywood cinema is basically an amalgamation of various styles and cultures originated from India itself. That's part one, because of the music, and because the music is very, very Indian and very Indianized. Unless and until they are trying to, you know, ape the West with getting their kind of instrumentations and that kind of style of music, then the dance changes. But Bollywood on its own is pure amalgamation of Indian various cultural folk dances.
So it depends on many fusion as well. And it, of course, originated from many folk and classical dances of India, which were used in the Indian cinema initially. And then they started fusing it with Western and other forms, African or American, or you say Southeast Asian countries. So that's what we see, that the influence is multiple in Bollywood dance. So tell us, as a Bollywood dance director, are they different from a Western film choreographer?
They are different from the Western choreographers only in one aspect. That is in your style of picturizing the song and taking the story ahead. Otherwise, to be very, very honest, every dance director, every song designer, every choreographer of the highest level will always look up to Western musicals, be it West Side Story, be it My Fair Lady, be it Singing in the Rain. They will be inspired by a tip or two and try to, you know, emulate those greats in their own small way. Having said that, I think I am one of those few who will actually call a spade by saying it, that I have always been inspired by Bob Fosse, by Gene Kelly, by Fred Astaire, because they were the ones who actually defined what dance should be in, in a film. And they're so cinematic. They made it look real and larger than life. So basically, when we've got some kind of an artist who's willing to play a role, and if that role demands that he needs to dance, then he's going to dance his backside off. And if that role demands that he doesn't need to dance, then he will be very suave. He'll be very cool and calm in a very somber manner. The song will be taken care of. But nonetheless, every artist always has that kind of flair that, you know, we need to go up and do a bit right out there. So dance is such an important aspect of filmmaking. Like, every choreographer has a dream that if he gets a chance to work with an artist, he wants that artist to do more than justice and glorify his personality. So that is what choreography is all about in, what do you say, Bollywood films. This is what a choreographer has to go through to make sure that the artist looks right up there, looks apt, and looks convincing to the public.
So what are the features of a Bollywood dance?
See, what makes a Bollywood dance number stand out is the originality, the way they would lip sync the song, the way they would enact the song with the words, keeping it lyrical in mind. You know, now it, back in the day, it used to sound very, very filmy, like, oh yeah, so filmy this person is, see how he's running around the trees. But maybe back in the day, that was what was given, that was available. Today, people are willing to go, you know, they are just going, sky is the limit. Like today, when you look at it in today's time and that time, nothing has changed. The technique has changed because technology has been available to everybody at the tip of their fingers. So that's one aspect which is taken care of. Then YouTube, social media. One song that has been dished out, there are 10 kinds of dances that take place on the same song. So people are hooked onto that. They love watching something new. So that becomes a novelty. So that also is derived from the West, bought into the Eastern side, bought into Bollywood, mixed and fused in the most appropriate way. And we've got talents who can actually move. And today's times, there was a time back in the day where the artist was there and there was huge, what do you say, bandwagon at the back. So people would know, okay, this artist is looking good because the bandwagon is so powerful and so sharp and so smart. But today, every artist is better than anybody else. And that's why he's there in front. Be it Varun Dhawan, be it Tiger, be it Hrithik Roshan, of course, Govinda, by all means. So everyone knows, okay, that is exactly what makes the Bollywood dances bigger, larger, and better. And they also look very, very bright because of the colorful costumes. The authenticity is taken into consideration. Every nuances that you see in a dance sequence is all adapted, you know, from various regions, from various cultures, and put together, fused in the most, what do you say, correct manner to make it look appealing, to make it look pleasing to the eye. And that's exactly what makes a song look different from many of the other songs that you see in the foreign, what do you say, videos or in the, what do you say, in English musicals. They look very good out there, but here it's got a fine touch. Like, you know, you have to walk that path to make it look more meaningful, to make it look a little bit more exciting. That's why we want to look at, what do you say, performers like Govinda, because he makes it look so interesting. He makes dance look interesting. So the idea of making a dance look interesting is all about the nuances that you can fill in to uplift the song.
Okay, so in that vein, would it be, you know, would you be able to discuss your own choreography with respect to any song and dance sequence that you designed recently or even earlier? And tell us about how did you go about designing that song and dance? Was it a part of the narrative? Did you have a sitting with the director and listen to the story and then understood the flow of the story and then how you want that song and dance to evoke that story aspect or things like that? So would you like to talk about any of the song and dance?
There's a wonderful song from this film called Shivai. It's called Bol Har Har Har. Now, believe me, there were a lot of meetings back and forth. By the time I came in, by the time my name was recommended, by Mr. Chandan Arora. He's an editor and he's also a filmmaker. And he told Mr. Devgan, like, you know, for a song like this, give me some time. I'll prepare something. I'll come with a presentation. So he came to me. We met. He said, Lonji, I want the song to look like this. This is what the film is all about. And by that time, the promos had hit the, what do you say, medium. And in all corners. And the promos was a huge, what do you say, hit from the word go. You know, straight away, 150 million for the promos. It's a very big thing. And people were like glued. They said, what's this? This is something new age. And then you have a song, which is a promotional track for the film. Now that had to be designed. So when you're designing a song, you will have to follow the lead of the director. The director over here, Mr. Ajay Devgan, the minute he met me, he gave me a free hand. He said, I've heard whatever you've said. And I've seen your presentation. I think it is brilliant. can we make it happen like this? And I said, sir, it will be maybe, it may be as good as this, but for sure it will also look better, because I know for the fact that we need to tap the right talent. So we got in the perfect people that who are talented and apt for that job. Then the makeup, then the clothing, then the lighting, then the style of shooting. And if you watch that song, and I'm sure you'll realize what I'm saying, that entire song happened to be a cult. It was a trendsetter. Today, every second song that is being done in a promotional manner is taking the pieces of what Shivai has done and adding it onto their, what do you say, songs, and putting that kind of flair and getting it done in that manner. Because now people have begun to realize, okay, what it means to make a song for your promotional track to uplift your entire film. So that's the key. When you're doing a promotional song, you need to uplift your film. So you're given a brief. Like now when you have a song like Bol Har Har Har, it's a powerful song. Then it's Shiva. Now the tandav that is there is aggression. Now there's nothing of Indian classical in that song. But the idea of getting aggression in that dance is what I got out. So that was a very, very big challenge. And that's what worked. Keeping the styling in mind, keeping it new age, keeping it modern, keeping it very contemporary. Like, you know, people should say like, wow, we have never seen something like this before. So that was my basic challenge. And that was my thought process. Okay, do something that has not been seen before. And I'm sure that I passed with flying colors. At least this is what I was told by Mr. Devgan.
So I would also like to ask you about your experience of working on Slumdog Millionaire and designing Jai Ho, which was a cult and still is a big cult, and it has been, you know, remixed and remade by so many popular, you know, Western pop groups like Pussycat Dolls and others. So tell us a bit about your experience of working with Danny Boyle, and how did you go about designing the song and dance?
Working with Danny Boyle was like a dream come true. Firstly, you meet somebody who's such a profound filmmaker. You know, he's an illustrious, what do you say, filmmaker, director, you name it, the works. Now that man, the bigger the name, the more humble that he was. This is all I can say. He looked so real and down to earth. That man gives you a free hand to do whatever you want to do. Now 5 a.m. in the morning, I had to travel 1.5-2 hours from my house to meet him at that set where they were shooting there. And when I reached there 15 minutes early, I thought I'll be the first person, but I'll tell you very honestly, I was the second, because Danny was the first man on the set. So that is the mark of that man. And when he saw that, he said, you know, Longinus, you're going to go a long way. I said, sir, we haven't even started, you know, what do you say, in our job. He's saying that's all irrelevant. The fact is that you're so honest with yourself and you're so passionate about your job that you have come here 15 minutes early. You never knew that I was around, but you're preparing what you're going to be showing the artist. The artist came in around about 5 o'clock sharp. And he told me one very nice thing. He's saying, Longi, I know you're very good in whatever you do, but I want you to be as simple as possible and keep it nice and pleasing to the eye, because my artists need to look good. That's it. And that was the key to the entire, what do you say, song, to make it a success, to keep it short, sweet and simple. Then when we were shooting, he gave me a free hand. He said, do whatever you feel you need to do. Do whatever is necessary. Do whatever is possible. And then we will even do the impossible. So that's a very big learning that I took on from that gentleman. And while I was on with the job, with 3,000 people on the set, on the station, it was an actual, what do you say, place. You know, the Victoria Terminus station in town, South Bombay. And when we shot there, he said, we've got time till 5 a.m. in the morning because the trains start after that. So your timing is from 12 a.m. to 5 a.m. So for those 5 hours, for 4 days, is what you have seen that entire song sequence. And in that time, the kind of planning that used to take place from 7 o'clock in the evening till 11 o'clock, because after that there would be a break for 1 hour, eat and then you're back on track. He told me one very good thing. He's saying, Lao Ji, whatever you do, apart from choreography, the main idea is about man management. If you can handle these people in the most appropriate manner, 50% of your job is done. And the remaining 50 is that we will try to manage with the people that we've got along with us, like the keys, like the head of departments, like the team, the associates, so on and so forth. While designing this song, he's always told me only one important thing to follow. He's saying, whatever you do, just make sure that the artists look natural and make sure that they don't try to dance. Dance should come naturally to them. So that's another big challenge. How does one make dance come naturally to you? Is what I learned from Mr. Danny Boy. And the rest is history. The rest is what the world has seen. So that was something which was a challenge, and that happened in the most remarkable manner. And mind you, Danny Boyle is a man of few words with a perspicacious eye. If he's seen something good about somebody, he will make sure that he gets the best out of him right till the end.
That's good to know. So, you know, you're talking about how Danny Boyle asked you to work around his actors. But as Bollywood is very star-driven, and a lot of times the dance directors have to work according to a star's dance particular ability. Okay. And do you find yourself, when as a choreographer, do you have to plan your dance moves according to the actor and what they can respond to and how they can carry? So how generally do you go about designing a dance for a particular star?
Let me put it this way. Now, if I get a chance, when I got a chance to work with Hrithik Roshan. Now, Hrithik Roshan was playing the character of a person who was disabled. He was as good as nothing in a movie called Guzarish. Okay. So he was seated in one, chair, and just watching this girl perform. And that girl was there out with him to make him feel great that this is going to be the best day of their lives. And she was all out to entertain him. So now when that brief has been given to you by a great filmmaker like Mr. Sanjay Leela Bhansali, so you know you can't go wrong. They have already got it up in their mind. So you have to play to the artist's strength. Now the artist is a great performer. Ashwarya Rai, I'm not saying she knows it all in a bad way. I'm saying she knows it all in a good way. She knows it all in the right manner that it is required for a dance sequence. They are so well trained. They are so, well versed, and they are matured. You know what I'm saying? So it makes a very, very big difference. So it is immaterial who the choreographer is or what the dance move is. If a dance move is so much, they'll make it so much. And if it is so much, then they'll make it so much. So that is the great respect that I have for a person like Aishwarya Rai Bachchan. And she did it with so much of flair, so much of flourish, and the kind of panache that she, has in her dance moves, the way she carries herself. It's simply incredible. She looked so ethereal when she was performing. So that was one good thing that I had seen in my life. Okay, if you have an artist who's strong, they will make your dance look stronger. They will make your dance look better. They will glorify your dance. They will glorify your dance even. There's nothing great about having a very good artist. There's nothing great about having them because they are supposed to be great in whatever manner that they are, capable of. And that's the beauty about an artist. Every artist is good. You'll be surprised to know that when I did the Mumbai Indians logo with Hrithik Roshan, that time he had some knee trouble. But when he saw the dance and the rehearsal, he said, my knee trouble is gone. And he came and performed. So, you know, this is what it is within an artist. The artist is so passionate that they forget. They actually forget the pain that they have been going through. So this is a given. Like when I worked with Govinda in a movie called Showman, no, there's no doubt about it that that film is still in completion. It is not yet, what you say, released. But believe it or not, he saw something. He said, "Lonnie bhai, aisa kuch kar jo main nahi karta, aisa kuch kar jo aap karte." So he was not happy to do the stuff that he's been doing all his life. They want to explore new avenues. They want to explore something new in the dance styles. They are all willing to learn. It's not that because they are good, so they will do that only. Like Tiger Shroff, if I get a chance to work with him, I'm going to make him do certain things which he has never done before. Because I know he is capable of doing that. Because he is one of the most agile and the most prim and proper performers I have seen in my life. He is simply international. He can match up to anybody in this world where dancing is concerned, because he's really trained himself and worked very hard. See, in today's time, what's happening, everyone is coming on the sets prepared. They don't want to come and then prepare themselves. They are all coming well prepared. So before hitting it, they are saying, "Boss, my dancing abilities, I know jazz, I know funk, I know contemporary, I know hip hop, I know various styles. Now tell me which style you want me to put in." So that's the plus point. Earlier, they only knew one style, filmy dancing style, be it the dipping or be it the expressions. Now they want to dance. Every artist is telling the, what you say, choreographers and the directors, "Ke bhai, hame nachao. Aisa kuch karo ke log kuch dekhe aur taliya bajaye, siti bajaye. To aisa kya hai? So aisa ye hai. So this is what it is." So they are all willing to walk that extra mile. So that's the plus point.
There's another aspect of Bollywood dance is something known as signature moves, or the hook steps are popular dance moves that are mostly intended to get the film going public to imitate the steps. Tell us about your approach to designing these signature moves or hook steps.
See, there are many people who used to do it earlier, but my great respect to the late Saroj Khan ji, who had actually taken that to the next level in Ek Do Teen. When I began my journey, the first song that I did was Bale Bale Ho Gaye Re with Baba Saigal. That was a rage. That was a rage. And when they saw that step, then people realized that simple thing was being done in every second marriage. Then there was another song, Dil Lege Kudi Gujarat Ki. You know what I'm saying? That was a bigger rage. So in every marriage, in every function, in every mehndi ceremony, this, that, chit chat, whatever, X, Y, Z, any kind of thing to do with dancing, people are like following that. So that helped me. So by the time when I came and I did Janleva, and when I did, what do you say, in Moksh, and when I did Pappu Khan dance and Jai Ho and all that, so that it only helped me grow and become better. So I was basically bettering my own self. So what new that you will bring on the table where people will find it not only easy, they'll find it nice to do. See, when you're doing something, people should also enjoy themselves. Now, this is something which I bought into the market. कि ऐसा कुछ करो कि लोग हंस हंस के करेंगे, यू नो, लाइक सम पीपल डू इट, बट देन दैट्स सीरियस, लाइक एक दो तीन वाज गुड एंड इट लुक्ड सो शार्प एंड स्मार्ट कि पीपल सेड यार क्या स्टेप है, एंड दे वर फॉलोइंग दैट. सो व्हेन आई गॉट इनटू द जोन, आई सेड आई विल ब्रिंग अ लिटिल ट्विस्ट टू इट. माय ट्विस्ट वाज व्हाट, टू ब्रिंग अ स्माइल ऑन पीपल्स फेस, कि इवन इफ अ मैन हु कांट डांस विल एटलीस्ट डू दैट स्टेप एंड फील लाइक अ डांसर. सो दैट इज वेयर आई मैनेज टू सक्सीड, एंड दैट इज व्हाट हैज एक्चुअली केप्ट मी गोइंग इवन टिल डेट. So I make sure that, you know, whatever, see, this is what dancing is all about. Actually, if you go to see, I've heard it from the greats. I've heard it from my parents. Okay, dancing is something where you have to shed your inhibitions. That's part one. Part two is that you need to be dancing as though you're enjoying yourself, not that you're being troubled. You know, there should be no bojha on your head. Arey yaar, abhi ye step karne ka hai. No, it should be like you're enjoying. So that's how it comes from within. And if it comes from within, then that dancer doesn't look like a dancer. He looks like a performer. Like Michael Jackson is a performer. Michael Jackson may not be the best dancer in the world, but I'm sure by far and large, he is the best performer that this world has ever seen. So that is what I have tried my best, you know, to emulate in my own small way. Okay, boss, do something which will bring a smile on people's face instantly. From 2 to 22, from 22 to 82, even that person also should be able to get up and dance. So there's no age bar.
My last question to you is, What is the creative process of designing a song and dance sequence? And I know it is very intense, and you just described some of two dance forms, dance that you did from Guzarish and Jai Ho, both ones. So what goes into the work of that? As a choreographer, how do you prepare? What is your preparation point? What are the things that you look for before getting into the designing? And then, of course, so the in a way, doing pre-production and then going into the production stage. What do you do as a choreographer?
See, let me put it in a very simple manner. The people like us who are all full of zest, you're going to bring something new on the table. For that new thing, you need to prepare. Now, preparation comes before success. That's even in the dictionary. So that has to be followed. You have to prepare. If you're doing a hook step, you have to not have only one and say, okay, you're convinced with this. You have to have at least 10. Ask the watchman who's outside your dance hall, okay, bhai, ye kaisa laga? Kya laga, sir? Maza aa gaya. So you need that kind of people. That's your audience. That's your audience. A rich man in the suit, the elite. Oh, wow, this is fantastic. Hey, it's so funny, man. I can do it. So that's when you know you have reached. So that preparation. Then you hear a song. And once you've heard it, follow the characterization of every principal artist. Follow what they are supposed to be doing in the movie rather than in the song. If you know what they are doing in the movie, in the song, they'll do it like this for you. You know what I'm saying? So that is what is very, very important. Understanding the character. Now your character is a fun-loving guy and you're giving him some serious dance moves. It's not going to work. It'll work for the song as a song which will come on Chhaya Geet or Chitrahar and Ariha Kya Gana Hai. But make sure the film, it will not get you the deserving accolades that you need to receive because you have not followed the path. So for that, you need a lot of preparation. You need to design something. If my artist is a fun-loving artist and he's a cool dude, then dress him up and make him sure that he's got that swag. Don't give him something which is over the top. And it's not going to be a part of his character. You know, so all these things come into the picture. So that is what preparation is all about. And it's a very good process and it's a healthy process. If people can have the patience to prepare once, twice, and then show your director, show your artist, because today's trend is this, the artist will come and see and he'll ask you, what am I doing? Hey, Longinus, show me what I'm doing. So I will plant my associate and say, okay, boss, this is you. So he's looking at that closely. He's saying, okay, fine, Longi, just show me once. Can you do it? So if I have to be prepared, I have to be prepared. If Arjun Rampal asked me and said, okay, Longi, I want to see it. I want to see you doing it. I want to know whether it is convincing or not. And that's the key. If you can do that, then boss, my salute to you. This is exactly what I like about people like Ganesh Hegde, Ganesh Acharya. You know what I'm saying? People like Vaibhavi. They will get up and dance. They will not wait for any other chance. You know, so this is what is important. You need to be on top of your game. Like I have made sure till date, age is not only a number. It is a number that is a part of it, but it's not only a number. Age is also a process and it's your thought process. The more you start thinking about it, you will never proceed. But if you let go and if you feel the way you are, then you will be sailing. If not, you'll be failing. So if you come with a process, if you come with a proper thought process for your song to be done, I'm sure you can never ever fail. I think this is the things what I have learned from Farah Khan, who's a very, a big filmmaker, an illustrious, choreographer to the highest level. The more I say, the less it would be. Because these are the kind of people who have done wonders. And they have not done wonders only for themselves to prove themselves. No, they have done wonders for cinema. Cinematically, they have shown the world what it is to get that liberty to do whatever you want to do and even to achieve it. Then having the kind of people whom you can trust and rely on, who can take your legacy forward. So I'm happy that I'm one of them that is taking some things forward. I've got some people who are with me. They have also taken something forward. So that's very, very good. So that's the way it should be.
Thanks so much, Longinus, for throwing light on so many of those things. And I'm sure this will help many to understand and view Bollywood song and dance in a new light. or with a renewed interest, especially after knowing that these sequences have many things going into the making and the creative process, which is very different and exciting. So thank you once again for joining us and talking to us and giving us so much of time.
To be very, very honest with you, I have enjoyed every minute of this conversation. Thank you.